so fine. I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design. Of rainbow design. Far over the water, I'd reach my magic band. So they'd understand. Come from Cotton Eye Joe. It's the old question again. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? And on this program, I'm going to try seeing if we can kind of experiment. I don't know what's going to happen myself, except that I'm going to sing some old-time songs from the United States of America. And we're going to hear some old-time songs from another country far over the ocean. They may be similar, they may be different. I don't know yet myself. But for my own side of the picture, I think I'll sing an old song out of pioneer days. I'll sing you a song, though it may be a sad one, of trials and troubles and where first begun. I left my dear family, my friends and my home, to cross the wide mountains and deserts to roam, to cross the wide mountains and deserts to roam. We heard of Sioux Indians all out on the plain, a-killing poor drivers and burning their train, a-killing poor drivers with arrow and bow. When captured by Indians, no mercy they'd show. When captured by Indians, no mercy they'd show. While taking refreshment, we heard a low yell, the whoop of Sioux Indians coming out of the dell. We sprang to our rifles with a flash in each eye. Boys, says our brave leader, we'll fight till we die. Boys, says our brave leader, we'll fight till we die. They made a bold dash and came near to our train. The arrows fell round us like hail and like rain. We shot their bold chief at the head of his band. They made a wild yell and away they all ran. They made a wild yell and away they all ran. We traveled by day and we guarded by night, till Oregon's mountains rose high in our sight. And there at Pocahontas beside the clear stream, our journey is ended in the land of our dream. Our journey is ended in the land of our dream. Like that song. It's a favorite of mine, but you know, I have to admit, it only gives one half of the story. A few years ago, my wife and I visited a Sioux Indian reservation on a dusty, dry corner of the state of South Dakota. And they sang me some of their songs, and I sang some. But I didn't sing this song. And somehow it gave me a new slant on the song I hadn't had before. I read in a history book, President Monroe says, why should these few people be holding a whole lot of territory because all they are hunters and gatherers of food, when farmers and settlers with industry can make much more full use of the land? Well, that was the justification, and the Sioux Indians are now on the reservation unless they want to live like white people. I don't know how I got so serious, though. Let me sing a happier song from pioneer days.
My pretty little pink, I once did think you and I would marry. But now I see you changed your mind and I'll no longer tarry. I'll put my knapsack on my back, my rifle on my shoulder, fly away to Mexico to be a valiant soldier.
Well, this one didn't turn out quite like I expected it to either.
I'll put my knapsack on the back, my rifle on my shoulder, fly away to Mexico to be a valiant soldier.
1844, that was. I was down in Mexico a while back. I didn't sing that song either. Let's try another.
Was in the town of Jacksboro in the spring of 73. A man by the name of Crego come stepping up to me. Said, how do you do, young feller, and how'd you like to go and spend one summer pleasantly on the range of the buffalo? It's me being out of employment to old Crego, I did say. This going out on the buffalo range depends upon the pay. But if you pay good wages and transportation too, I think, sir, I will go with you to the range of the buffalo. Oh, yes, I'll pay good wages and transportation too, if you will come and go with me and stay the summer through. But if you do grow homesick and home would you do go, I'll not pay transportation from the range of the buffalo. Well, it's now we've crossed Pease River, boys, our troubles have begun. The first old buffalo that I skinned, Christ, how I cut my thumb. While skinning the damn old stinkers, our lives they had no show. For the Indians watched to pick us off while skinning the buffalo. He fed us on such sorry chuck, I wish myself most dead. It was old jerk beef and sourdough and rotten sour bread. And the mosquitoes and the chintzes, our lives they had no show. I'll tell you, there's no worse hell on earth than the plains of the buffalo. Well, the season was near over, and old Crego, he did say, the crowd had been extravagant, we were in debt to him that day. Well, we coaxed him and we argued, but still it was no go. We left his damn old bones to bleach on the range of the buffalo. Well, now we've crossed Pease River, boys, and homeward we are bound. No more in that all-fired country will ever we be found. Go back to our wives and sweethearts, tell others not to go. For God's forsaken the buffalo range and the damn old buffalo.
I got on so many violent type songs. Not all Americans are so violent. A friend of mine, her grandmother was a Quaker down in North Carolina. She taught me a song. You see, her grandmother said, taught it to her, says, honey, this is my favorite song and I wish you'd always remember it. It was made up in the days when people like us were not free to speak our own mind. My life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation. I hear the real, though far off, hymn that hails a new creation. Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear that music ringing. It sounds an echo in my soul. How can I keep from singing? What though the tempest loudly roars, I hear, I know the truth, it liveth. What though the darkness round me close, songs in the night it giveth. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, can I keep from singing? When tyrants tremble, sick with fear, and hear their death knells ringing, when friends rejoice, both far and near, how can I keep from singing? In prison cell and dungeon vile, our thoughts to them are winging. When friends by shame are undefiled, how can I keep from singing? Will, I'm going to introduce some friends of mine. Two old friends and one new friend. Because here after singing a couple songs of old-time America, how we went west, across the Mississippi River, across the plains, across Texas to California, now Americans have... We have our 50th state in Hawaii, and Americans have gone even farther. I wanted to hear them, and I'd like you to hear them too. Steve Addiss and Bill Crofut, golly, I knew them when they were kids in school. In fact, I was a teacher of one of them when I was a music teacher about 15, 20 years ago. And since then, they've traveled around the world themselves, singing songs, many different places, dozens of different countries, giving people in other countries a taste of American folk music. And in the country of Vietnam, they met an extraordinary musician named Pham Duy, spelled D-U-Y, but I'm told it's pronounced Duy. I only just met him just before we went on the air. But I know about him because I heard his record, his folkways record of, he's collected songs all over Vietnam, north and south, for 20 years. He walked from village to village, writing down songs with pencil and paper till he could afford a tape machine and recorded them on tape. And I heard some of the old folk songs of the little villages way back in the hills, the songs of the rice farmers and so on. He's not only a collector of Vietnamese folk music, but he's a songwriter. And altogether, a very interesting guy. And I think, no matter who you are, it'd be interesting to meet him. So in just a moment, we'll pour out the coffee cups here, and we'll meet Steve Addiss, Bill Crofut, and Mr. Pham Duy. Pham Duy. Like most Americans, what I know about Vietnamese music could be written on my fingernail. And I'm very glad to meet you and hear some of these songs and hear this unusual-looking instrument. What do you call it?
Vietnamese call đàn chanh, but
call đàn chanh, đàn chanh, đàn chanh.
But it is a zither.
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 Some kind of zither.
Oh, some kind of a zither. Yes. Well, they have these all through the Orient. The Japanese koto is a little this.
And in China, people play also the đàn chanh, but it's called kin.
I see.
You know, the when you say these words in Vietnamese and one thing or another, they're music in themselves. You know, it's a tonal language like Chinese.
Well, you mean the same word can mean different things if you say it high or low?
Well, sometimes it's very funny. For example, if you're supposed to say Vietnam, Vietnam, and if you say it like some of the administration officials say it, Vietnam, it comes out meaning dying duck.
Well, I'd be interested to hear some of the old songs first. Can you give us, tell us a little about them too, because I'd like to know where it came from and what the words mean.
You know, maybe you are surprised if I sing Vietnamese old song with a guitar. But I think when I was 10, I played already guitar. That means the guitar came in Vietnam 40 years, more than 40 years ago.
So now all young people in Vietnam know the guitar.
Yes, and they play also electric guitar, like Beaton. In the ancient time, Vietnamese has many fair songs. That means after the harvest.
People, like our harvest festival.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Like here is a very old song. The title is Trèo Lên Quán Dốc. That means Full Moon Fair. Trèo lên quán dốc, ngồi gấp ngôi nhà cây đa, rằng tôi ly ôi nhà cây đa. Ai đem ôi nhà tính toán tình rằng, cho đôi mình gặp, xem hồi cái đêm trăng rằm, rằng tôi ly ôi nhà cây đa. Che che ra hàn non kia nó nói à ba tâm tôi đi ơi tâm ba thơ ai đã nói à tính to tình rằng cho anh chàng mặc xem hội cái đôi chẳng rầm rằng tôi đi ơi à cây đa rằng tôi đi ơi à cây đa che che ra hàn non kia nó nói à ba tâm tôi đi ơi tâm ba tâm ai đã nói à tính to tình rằng cho anh chàng đội xem hội cái đêm trăng rầm rằng tôi ly ôi à tháng riêng rằng tôi ly ôi à tháng riêng.
Well, now in the old days, would this kind of a song be sung always by one person, or would groups of people sing it together ever?
They sing like I am a boy, you are a girl. You sing like in duo.
Duo. Ah.
Duo, yeah.
Duet.
That's from the north, is
yes,
right?
From the north.
Where you're born.
The old Vietnamese folk song, all are on only the pentatonic system. That means five tones. Do, re, fa, sol, la, sol, fa, re, do.
Like the black notes on a piano.
I noticed, though, studying music with musicology with Pham Duy and some of the other instruments, that in South Vietnam, the pentatonic scale, because of influences from basically India, not directly through India, but tribal minorities, the Champa kingdom, which used to be in South Vietnam, that the pentatonic scale begins to switch.
Yes.
So instead of da da dee dee dee, it goes da da dee dee dee, da 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 dee dee dee, and so forth.
Yes.
It begins to sharpens. Bend a little bit.
Well, that's what you do with this instrument.
Yes.
Yes, this instrument is now tuned for
South
Vietnamese.
Yes, for East of South Vietnamese.
I mean, Steve Addiss, you're going to play it, not Pham Duy.
Oh, he plays maybe better than me.
No.
Because he loved me. He was in Vietnam and he loved me.
But this, you can see how it's tuned.
That means do re fa son la do now becomes do mi fa son la do la son fa mi do.
And I believe when you play this instrument, is what they call the left hand makes the player. It's the little additional things that you do on the other side of the bridge. If you play this note, that's all right. But when you reach that note, you're supposed to give it a little.
Uh-huh. And do that again.
And on this note, on the fourth note, you're supposed to raise it a little bit. Like it would be between F and F sharp somewhere. And the third note, which I have now sort of a major third, can really be halfway between. It's a little hard. It's musicians to taste, I think. Some make there, some others.
Sour lemon in the sauce.
First time I heard the musicians play this, I said, they're awfully good, but why don't they get into tune? Then I realized it was my ear that was out of tune. But perhaps a little bit of, can you explain a little of Li Con Chau?
Yes, it is a children's song in Vietnamese, South Vietnam. Li Con Chau, that means a song for the little bird.
Little birds?
Yes.
Starling?
Black bird, I don't know.
Oh, I could just have in the picture of my mind the fields of rice and the trees and some person sitting outside a grass-roofed thing playing this to themselves. And
it's
the only sound is some birds.
Yes.
It's an instrument that I think traditionally the young girls particularly learn. Perhaps our great-grandmothers might have learned the spinet, you know, the long black hair and the beautiful Vietnamese dress that the girls wear and playing this instrument, it's very, very beautiful.
Mm.
Very, very beautiful.
I can't keep my hands off it.
you can tune it with a peg, but these bridges are also for fine tuning. And it's wonderful fun.
You know, I think we should tell Peter a little bit how all of this came about. You're studying this instrument and are going to Vietnam and one thing or another. I think the reason we've sort of followed up on a particular interest in Vietnamese music is because in all the countries we've gone to, we've rarely been to a country where we met somebody that took us in the same way that Pham Duy did. He was there the night we arrived, and he took us out to have a Vietnamese dinner the first day we ever got there, and started singing Vietnamese songs and teaching them to us. And he went with us, without pay, just because he wanted to hospitals, orphanages, schools, universities, hamlets, out in the countryside. And it was his presence that made the thing so meaningful. I was mentioning last night to some people that in this whole political thing, I wish we had more politics who could look at countries' problems through the best of their expressions, their music, their art, their literature, because it leads to such a greater understanding of things.
Yes, I think it's so much in the news today, Vietnam, and yet we don't know really very much about the country and the people. And I think with Pham Duy here to just to tell a little bit about
Sing another song and tell us about it.
Yes.
You're next.
You know, if you hear Vietnamese folk song, old folk song, like you recognize, you imagine rice, fin, you imagine flower, you imagine bird, and you imagine peace. All folk songs are talking about peace. But now in Vietnam, we have many songs talking about war. I think it's the moment I will sing the song at daytime, present time. But if you want to know about more Vietnamese people, I will sing for you. Also, love song, fair song at first. And after that, I will sing for you the song of today. And you see the difference. You see how Vietnamese people are suffering 20 years ago. So now let's sing a love song, very old love song. The meaning of this song is, I love you. I offer to you my dress. When I come back, my parents ask for me, where is your dress? I answer to my parents, the wind blow on the bridge and I lose my dress.
Wind on the bridge.
Yêu nhau, yêu nhau, cô nhau, cho nhau về nhà, rồi rằng cha rồi mẹ ngóng này ở ngôi nhà của cầu này ở ngôi nhà của cầu tình 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 gió bay tình 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 gió bay yêu nhau cội nhớ nỗi à cho nhau về nhà rồi rằng cha rồi mẹ này ở ngôi nhà của cầu tình 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 đôi rơi tình 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 đôi rơi.
Let's have one more before we take a break. What would it be?
Jesus.
How about before we get to the new songs, maybe we can all sing the rice planting song?
Yes, I know.
All up.
Yes,
all
I know.
Good. This is a song that Pham Duy taught us the first day we got to Vietnam, a working rice planting song. And when we traveled throughout the country, people would see Bill or see me walking down the street and they'd say, Mr. Ha Le, because the song is Ha Le. Yeah.
Nào cao cho bằng đèn châu đơn, gió nào độc cho bằng gió gò cơn. Vợ chồng son đã nuôi lòng ước mơ, con vợ chồng sẽ cùng tớ biển đông. Hò lơ lắng tai.
Some more songs from Phan Duy and Steve Addiss and Bill Crofut. Take a break here, and who wants more?
Thank you, Mr. Seeger.
We've heard three or four of the older Vietnamese folk songs, and now Phan Duy. I think I and the others would like to hear some of the newer songs of Vietnam.
Yes, sir. Vietnam people consider if folk song are the mirror of the past. Folk song must also to be the reflection of the present time. So, as you know, 20 years ago, Vietnam is the war time. So I would like to sing for you one very old song. 20 years ago, I composed it when I was in the North area. The title is Người Thương Binh. Means the wounded soldier.
Phan Duy,
what is the
wounded soldier.
The wounded soldier.
Phan Duy told me that he composed this 20 years ago when he was with the Viet Minh. And one day, some years later, he went into a village and asked them to sing folk songs he was collecting. And they sang them this song as a folk song, which must be a wonderful honor to know that a song that he had written had really become one. It says, I think if I'm correct, that the first verse, the girl is saying goodbye to her husband who was going off to fight in the war. And in the second verse, he comes back and he has lost his arm.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, he is welcomed back by his family and the whole village.
She loves him two times more than in the past.
Yeah. Even she loves him twice as much as before.
Something like that. Cho anh ra đi chia thu, từng ngày chiến thiên hòa thu,
từng ngày chiến thiên hòa thu,
từng ngày chiến thiên hòa thu, có chàng ra đi biển hồ ai đi. Năm xưa ra đi chốn này, chàng về nơi đã cụt tay, chàng về nơi đã cụt tay, chàng về nơi đã cụt tay, màu đầu đã nhuốm trên thây bao nhiêu.
Thank you. You're a couple of years. Thank you.
Well, this little bamboo flute, I learned how to play from a fellow who came from Israel. And whenever
Israel.
I come
up, Israel.
And whenever I find a tune that's got five notes in it like that, Yes. I can usually find a way to fit in, even though I've never heard it before. Oh, that's beautiful. And you wrote that 20 years ago.
Yes, yes.
Have you written many songs?
Yes, sir.
300? 400?
We have more than 300 songs already.
How are they spread around? Are they in song books?
Yes, I have published many, many books. And books.
And recordings?
Records, yes,
too.
Yes. Hmm? Well, very, people now in Vietnam has only music to rely on the suffering.
In many ways, he's the Woody Guthrie of Vietnam. And he's walked the entire length of the country, I think you mentioned that, and written songs about the people, not the governments, but
sing
the
another.
Peasants.
Sing another.
Yes, sir. Now in Vietnam, we have a song very popular. These people like this song because it reflects now the feeling of our people. The title is Nhân Danh.
On behalf.
Yes, on behalf. I am very sorry to you.
Steve, why don't you explain a little bit about this?
This is a song which Pham's we can sing two different ways. Perhaps you can translate as you go, and then we will explain if people, if there are any questions.
It is also a protest song.
It is a
but
protest
not only
song.
Protest. Protest and propose one solution. Vì sự mình tôi phải giết vài giết giết một người giết một người xin nhân danh ngồi dưới For my defense, I must kill one man. For my place in the sun, I must kill one man. Vì gia đình tôi phải giết, giết mười người, giết mười người. Xin nhân danh hạnh phúc là gọi. Vì gia đình tôi phải giết mười người. For the family, I must kill 10 men on behalf of prosperity. I must kill 10 men. Vì xóm làng tôi phải giết, giết ngàn người, giết ngàn người. Xin nhân danh ruộng đất nẹp mỏi, xin nhân danh ruộng đất nẹp hỏi giết ngàn người. For the village, I must kill 100 of men on behalf of bigger land. I must kill 100 of men. Vì dông nói tôi phải giết, giết vạn người, giết vạn người. Xin nhân danh tổ quốc đẹp người. Vì dông nói tôi phải giết vạn người. For the nation, I must kill 1,000 of men. On behalf of fatherland, I must kill 1,000 of men. Lý tưởng tôi phải giết, giết triệu người, giết triệu người. Xin nhân danh giải phóng loài người. Vì lý tưởng tôi phải giết triệu người. For my ideology, I must kill millions of men. To liberate all mankind, I must kill millions of men. Nhân loại tôi còn giết giết trọn loài người giết trọn loài người xin nhân danh đường lối hòa bình xin nhân danh đường lối hòa bình giết luôn tôi for the human race I must kill everything else on behalf of the lasting peace I must kill myself.
Is that the end of the song?
Yes.
Good God.
You know, in Vietnam, when I sing this song, people applaud me. But I talk to the people, to the audience. I apologize, but I must to refuse your applause. Because you don't have to applaud a killer. On behalf of many beautiful things, they push the people to kill the people. So because of he approached me, I must to sing another way. For defense. I must save, would save, save one man, save one man. For my blessed in the soul, for my defense, I must save one man. For family, I must save 10 men. On behalf of prosperity, I must save 10 men. For the village, I must save 100 men. On behalf of meager land, I must save 100 of men. For the nation, I must save 1,000 of men. On behalf of fatherland, I must save 1,000 of men. For my ideology, if I have one, I must save millions of men. To liberate all mankind, I must save millions of men. For the human race, I must save everything else. On behalf of the lasting peace, I must save at first myself. That is a proposition. One protestation supposed to have one proposition. It is the title of On Behalf. Thank you, sir.
I heard you rehearsing one that you all three do together. Have you taught Bill and Steve another one of your songs?
This is a song you wrote about a year ago, and it's... I get so shook by the other song, it's hard. But this is a very beautiful song called The Rain on the Leaves, Sat Mua Chin La, and we've worked a way to do it both in Vietnamese and in English for people.
Steve, translate into English.
Passionate voice in a fire.
I once made up a song how the world was getting all mixed up and how our food and our language and just about everything else was getting all tangled with things from one country visiting another and mixing. Whatever you want to call it, for good or bad, this is going on. And son of a gun, I found out they know an old American tune and have Vietnamese words to it either, even. And when I say American tune, though, come to think of it, it was actually originally a Mexican tune. How it got to Mexico, I don't know. It might have been a European tune. But in 1849, the gold miners heard this little tune. Boom, 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 and somebody swiped the tune and had a big pop hit out of it. And you, of course, you all know it very well. I don't know what words they sing to it in Vietnam, but I want to see myself. Let me get around and back so I can find out what it is. What are the words about?
About a works who has big
sandals?
Big feet. Yes.
Big feet.
Yes. When she found out the lower can, because he cannot to swim, he cannot to swim.
Because he has such big feet.
He cannot save her
swim
from the river.
Something like that.
I sing?
Yes.
Nơi hàng sâu đây, trên non cao này, mỏ than ấy có dân di cư. Và trong đám đó có một gia đình để gái sinh lò thêm một thai. Ôi em yêu kiều, ôi em yêu kiều, người yêu dấu hơi Clementine. Em đã khuất núi, em đã qua đời, buồn cơm ghê rồi, Clementine. Đầu em huy hoàng như tiên trên trần, làn tóc sáng với đôi chân to. Giày cao ông mới ôm cổ chân dài, giày rất oai của Clementine. Em yêu kiều, ôi em yêu kiều, người yêu dấu hơi Clementine. Em đã khuất núi, em đã qua đời, buồn cơm ghê rồi quên thai.
Steve, play it on me.
Ra đây sông đầy, em đi chân bay, bay ra xuống sớm tôi em vui. Rồi em vấp ngã, chân nắng đôi giày, buồn cơm ghê rồi. Ôi em yêu kiều, người yêu dấu hơi Clementine. Em đã khuất núi, em đã qua đời, buồn cơm ghê rồi Clementine. Trôi trên sông đầy, trôi trên sông dài, nhìn lớp sóng, sóng cuốn em trôi. Ôi anh hai ơi, không tập bơi lội, đánh mất em.
Some more verses. We've got plenty of time.
Ôi em yêu kiều, người yêu dấu hơi Clementine. Em đã khuất núi, em đã qua đời, buồn cơm ghê rồi Clementine. Khi hoa trong vườn, khi bông hoa hương nở to tướng cuốn dưới các chuông. Ta tin chắc chắn hoa được phun trồng thơm hương nở. Ôi em yêu kiều, người yêu dấu hơi Clementine. Em đã khuất núi, em đã qua đời, buồn cơm ghê rồi Clementine.
We have time just to sing a chorus. Let's do it in English so the poor people out there will be able to join in. Oh my darling, oh my darling, oh my darling Clementine. You are lost and gone forever, dreadful sorry Clementine. Oh my darling, oh my darling, oh my darling, Clementine, you are lost and gone forever. Oh, had I a golden thread and needle so fine, I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design.
In it I'd weave the bravery of women giving birth. In it I'd weave the innocence of children over all the earth. Children of all earth, far over the waters, I'd reach my magic band. City, through every single land, through every land. Sure, my brothers and my sisters, my rainbow designs.